Hello and welcome back. My apologies again for the previous episode, but I couldn't believe it on a high note or anything that is, you saw. The level of frustration was simply ramping up too quickly. And speaking of which, I did not take you with you for the second phase of this engagement. For the simple reason that, for one, I wasn't in the mood to talk over to commentate the fight, and for the other one, it wasn't really that interesting to begin with. As you can see here, the Satan Sons, they just bunched up over here and we took them out, but even then we went into some difficulty, not related to the fight itself actually, but there was yet another bug, believe it or not, relating to the improved interrupt system, I suspect. Sometimes, if we took shots at them, they would, I don't know, the proc would attempt to take these suppression effects into account, but instead would just lock up entirely. I know, a deadlock. The game is supposed to auto-resolve those after 30 seconds at the longest, but it just did not happen. So I had to force quit the game every time. So even though we had some shots perfectly lined up in front of us, we couldn't take them. Instead we have to let the enemy inflict damage and suppression here, for instance on Leon. So that was dumb to say the least, and also, you know, not a nice boost to my motivation here, so what can you do? But we pulled through this engagement, and we looted everything, and there wasn't really any good finds here, to be honest. All of these guys, they didn't drop any of their armor, unfortunately, but we did find a Kevlar jacket at the very least to complete our sets here of chest equipment, a Kevlar vest, and now everyone has at least some basic protection, be it in various states of disrepair, but we can get worked on that, we can get started on that later. The other sector, I had to do this obviously, I mean the subway one at Atrimo, since Leon was broken. Beyond repair, there was absolutely no way to fix him. I tried to salvage that save file, but it was not to be. Fortunately though, we didn't lose too much progress, although our layout has changed a little bit since the enemy over there in Atomo, they didn't drop the same items. So instead of a pepper spray and a stun gun, we now have a taser on finger and wrist, but yeah. We even tried this out during this engagement, but it didn't seem to be too effective. We fired 3 shots, which is the maximum you can get here from one a battery. Okay, it inflicted some damage, but it didn't really drain the stamina, which this thing should do, really. One shot should knock someone out, no problem. Especially since this does have the ignore all armor property. Maybe I will look into this after this video here and fix this, because it seems like a terrible useless item at the moment. Yeah, I know I didn't want to mod this game, but I know where to look for. It's just in the ammo types, and you switch some flex around, some varios, and that might do the trick. It's really just 50 minutes of work. I can do this before I go to bed or something like this while watching videos on YouTube. Yeah, yeah, and then we have this wooden shield here. I think I mentioned this before, that there are multiple types of ballistic shields in the game. And it does appear, contrary to what I've said before, that we can actually use this thing in our offhand as protection and then fire with a one-handed grip here in the other one. But I'm not sure if this is entirely the case, because it says here this item requires both hands to be used, but the animation doesn't change, so no one shot at mouse here in this engagement. But if we were to use this in this configuration, I'm not sure if it offers any protection or not. And also we cannot repair this item. So that's, it could take maybe a couple of bullets here, absorb a couple of 9x18 macro of slugs or something like this, but after that we'll probably have to drop it. It's just already, pretty crappy condition to start with, so, alright. Well, we give it a try.
Ready.
And then otherwise, I think, we had another find here, a sort of shotgun, the most basic of, scatter guns here. Terrible accuracy, terrible range, and it's not the best condition either, but this range here, we're going to use that at 5 or 10 times range at the most. And then I think this is a new statistic. I think that means there are 9 pellets here in each buckshot cartridge, I mean shell is the term, excuse me. And every single pellet has the potential for to inflict 10 damage. Yeah, so it's if they read it correctly. Of course, it wasn't the case in 4870, so yeah. We can try it out at close range, I suppose, and if it's, it turns out to be not any good, then we just drop it and keep the ammo, because it certainly would be useful for a more a more sensible shotgun, something with a stock and a long barrel on it. You can actually shoot down at longer ranges, it would be great. Yes, and we expend also a little more ammunition that I had wanted to, because yeah. 9x18 doesn't really matter so much, we can pick this up after every battle, but 5x6 NATO and 223 Remington, that's unfortunately a different story, so we have to conserve those magazines as much as possible. Alright, and that brings me to a little predicament we find ourselves in here. I mean, you see this equipment, you see these people, okay, we have, we found these long arms here. This was a very good find, very good boost here. A force multiplier almost, even though technically it's not one. Yeah, we are really constrained here in terms of, like I said, just ammo usage. We have to really watch those reserves here, but otherwise, okay.
I'm ready.
We have some pretty decent machine pistols, this Agram 2000 for instance, and the PM63 is also a step above the Scorpions, these FPSs. Okay, we can fire them akimbo at close range, and well done could make this happen in theory if we were to aim low and then let Muscle climb and do the rest, but she would need some sort of long arm to take advantage of her good combination of dexterity, marksmanship, and wisdom, so she could probably control a submachine gun on full auto from the crouch position or from the prone position, and we would really need those. Because thanks to ESA, we have some intel on the situation upstairs. And if you take a look at this, then we can see, okay, we have 9 guys in the sector, 11 here, okay, 12, and 7. So that's manageable for us. I think we could take them on. But over here in the most important mine sector, actually factory sector, of course. I keep forgetting this is not the stock campaign, of course, this is Quipperton factory. There are 27 dudes in here, and this is absolutely out of our league. We have absolutely no way we could take them on, certainly not at the same time. If we can, I don't know, split the forces in some way, perhaps we could make this happen, but not more than 10 enemies at the most, and even these 12 guys over here, this could be a little of a dicey engagement, depending on how it goes. We can't really control this, I mean, to a certain extent, maybe, but yeah. Let's not forget that the enemy isn't stupid in this build. They will actively flank you and try not to bunch up, you know, the civilians down there notwithstanding. I mean, the other engagements I've seen the army act a little more intelligent than this. So we shouldn't get too confident there. Yeah, so but what options do we have? We could clear out the rest of Callisto, okay, but since I have disabled reinforcements, it works both in our and against our favor. Since we can defeat these forces a piecemeal, but not split them up here, I don't think. So that's a little difficult. I mean, we have one mercenary here capable of disguising themselves with the covert ops trait, and we could even maybe sort of solo this guy, these seven guys down here, if they are if they are too far apart to support or even see each other, then we could probably make it 7 stealth kills and be done with it. Might be something worth trying out. I mean, or even off screen, where I don't care so much about safe scumming, when it comes to experimentation. But otherwise, yeah, we need really 27 guys. That's not doable. So let's see on our options here. Yeah, we could go to Port Kip instead, but there are two problems with this. This is not even in the game. There will be regular enemies over here just as well. And there is no mine to help us out. And maybe a couple of quests. I'm not sure how they have repurposed the Extreme Fighting Competition, for instance. And I'm sure there is some sort of Tony knockoff here with Hood by Guns. But we don't really have... okay, we have a vehicle here, the UAZ, but how do we get over there? And these machine pistols, they aren't even worth that much, to be honest. Even if we were to, I don't know, fill the entire trunk with those, okay, then we get 3,000, 4,000 at most. It's not worth the trouble. And then we have to fight our way for here, to actually use the road, since this it might go off-road, I guess, but I'm sure there are more roaming patrols over here who would get in our way regardless. So if we don't have the advantage in tactics or numbers, then what about equipment? Can we make this happen? Well, and Bobby Race has some good guns on offer in the used section. I mean, more advanced than we should have access to at the moment, but they're all in crappy condition. And okay, if we pay for overnight shipping, I would get here tomorrow at 11, I think. Okay, then we would have to waste the entire rest of the day. That's one thing. Okay, we could get some of our equipment repaired up, perhaps. That would be good for us, especially those flak jackets here. Yeah, or this, I don't know, it's something Kevlar. I'm not sure if this uses Kevlar. Yeah. Multi-layer protective vest, so it's not specific here, but I'm sure it's some sort of lighter material. We don't have any access to plates, so don't even think about it at the moment. Alright, well, okay, then we have some decent equipment, but even though, I mean, okay, we can repair this to full condition, but even then, it's not really, it doesn't offer that much, really. Okay, so we cannot order better ABE gear. I think it's only a flak jacket available from Bobby Race anyway, so actually we are better served with what we have in that regard. So, okay, then we order a long arm or two and then waited for it to arrive, but then we have to fix it up. And if you go with something which isn't available yet, then we would have to import every single bullet as well and on top of it. And I'm not sure we can even get, let's take a pick here. If we were to go with that one Muslim gun in use section, could we get any ammo for it? And the answer to that is nope, cannot. So it's only 9x19 for the... for the Calico rifle, for instance. It's not fully automatic, yeah, but it's certainly way more accurate than anything we have, except for the two AR-15 rifles. And for Beltran, for instance, she could keep the APSs for close-up engagements, and then the Calico as a long arm. Mm-hmm, that could work for us. And let's not, yeah, I did look at the, yeah, that one in particular down here, the Rossi, yeah, that Rossi rifle here in 45 code. Because this has the longer barrel here, I mean, excuse me, it's of course nonsense, the longer cylinder here is perfectly sized to chamber 410 bore as well, so we could use it as a combination gun and then switch out, you know, 45 code and 410 bore shells as necessary. These are not fully interchangeable. I mean, if you have a firearm, it doesn't matter if it's a handgun or a shotgun or a rifle in 410 bore, you know, with a chamber which is actually long enough to chamber these shotgun shells, then yes, you could also use 45 code, but you cannot take, I don't know, an old West revolver, chamber for 45 code, and then stuff 410 shotgun shells in that thing. That doesn't match. I think it's like 3 times the case length, so that doesn't work, but otherwise, this would be, in this case, it would work, since it is based on the Taurus Judge revolver. Yeah, that could work for us, and it's fairly affordable as well. It's only a matter of getting it here. Express shipping is very expensive, and we, yeah, these ammo boxes, they, since we don't buy individual magazines, but, you know, entire ammo boxes instead, they're also pretty heavy. I would suspect we can check this real quick. So 45 SP, we don't worry about this, but the ball here. So, weight, it's 1.1 kilograms, so it's not too heavy, but if you want, you know, some shotgun shells to go along with it, yeah, then 3 kilograms here for box of slugs for longer range accuracy, and then we also want buckshot, of course, for open engagements, yeah, that's another 3 kilograms. And I also thought about, you know, why do we have a 38 special here, and not any, no firearms to go along with it in the rifle section? Well, that's because that Winchester 1894 we saw and used, you know, the used category, it chambered for 357 Magnum, and I'm guessing what is most likely the opportunity here would be to switch this over via the item transformation button there to 38 special, and then we could use this most likely. And this is cheap and relatively light and also relatively effective, and it's the only caliber right now we can get in Glazer, Glazer ammo for. These Glazers have these slugs. If you don't know what it is, that's this has been designed for to avoid over-penetration at all costs, so this is excellent against unarmored targets, certainly even compared to hollow points, but utterly and utterly useless against even the lightest body armor, and you also cannot pierce any cover. With, I mean, it was specifically designed so even a light wooden wall would offer enough protection, you know, to actually stop this. Since the idea behind this was for, you know, for air marshals on aircraft, as well as, you know, police units, you know, in apartments or something like this, you don't want to accidentally shoot through a wall, you know, a thinner wall, and then you know, injure some bystander there, someone in the other apartment. I mean, the apartment next door or something like this. So, I mean, that could be a good course of action for us at least. We don't have to raid around here and do nothing. We could take out the rest of Callisto certainly, and then wait for equipment to arrive, and then take on the factory here. I mean, as long as we don't take out all of Callisto, the reinforcement event shouldn't trigger, I think. So maybe that's something we could do, and this is, might be an option for us, since we cannot get any, as far as rifles go, excuse me, we have to check it again. Yeah, let's forget about 22, I don't think it's worth bothering with. Okay, we can make use of this right now against the enemy, so sure, okay. But once they start wearing flak jackets, then we have wasted, I don't know, not too much money on the rifle and the ammo combined, but even then, we should watch our bottom line very, very carefully, or very closely, I should say. Yeah, so 30 carbine we could get, one rifle for this new section. So, but this is not native to this country, we would have to import every single one of those. The same one with 48 special, actually, but yeah. It seems to be a little more plentiful. We do get 50 rounds here. Okay, this is also 50 rounds. Well, then never mind, but we have a larger selection here at the moment, and I'm not sure when 20 carbine armor piercing will show up. And we don't have an M1 variant here available, or you know, some variant here of the Enfield or the Medford. I'm not sure what is in this game here. Yeah, so that could work for us, as well as the Calico. Okay, and something automatic. Okay, we have 3 guns with decent accuracy and decent range, which are also automatic. So we have the 2 AR-15 rifles or carbines, but we don't have the ammo to spare. So with actually the same problem with Ellie's PP-19, even though 9x19 should be plentiful, it is not. We cannot get this here in the country, not as an enemy drop, so we would have to buy it as well. And the thing is, okay, we have some magazines here, but these would be completely wasted on these basic ones, because this is overpressure, which is, I'm sure, is coolness 5 or 6 or something like this. So, we do not want to expend this on these basic enemies if we can avoid it, you know. So I even put in the remaining 10 rounds here of Wagner ball ammo in this thing, since, it did seem to be a bit of a waste. So, well, yeah, so I think what we're going to do is to buy some equipment and then occupy ourselves here with cleaning out the rest of Callisto, because when we take the bottom entrance, the bottom exit, I should say, this actually leads to the second sector. This one here with the 7 dudes inside, and that absolutely should be a problem for us. Assuming we don't get, you know, surprised from around the corner and then fail to get the interrupt, it could be the case. Since I haven't worked out the finer points of the improved interrupt system yet, so we can get started with this. And then depending on how it goes, we can even do a two-in-one episode, but we cannot get here, maybe. I mean, through the sector. There isn't another entrance for us to take, so we have to go the long way around, I suppose, and it would take quite some time, I assume, since it does not count within city limits. Yeah. Maybe we could sneak past, I suppose, with our covert ops guy. But then, actually, it's not the worst of ideas. We could clear the way, you know, check for enemies in our way, and maybe even take one or two stealth kills if it came to that, and then move our entire squad to north here. But then how do we get back to the subway to pick our stuff in the Trimo? So it's something for me to consider off screen here. So yeah, sorry that there isn't another fight in this video, but I really do not feel like running into another game breaking bug at the moment. So, and there was also a lot to discuss about, and I think it's important. Since this is a series here, a let's play, it would be unwise for me to leave out important pieces of information. It would lose coherence and context and be quite confusing, I suspect. Yeah, so once again, thanks for watching, and I hope to get back to you next time here with a proper fight in our hands.